This
Hello.
conference will now be recorded.
So let's talk about now access group, access roles, access role to object and privileges. See, you already aware of what is an access group. Access group is going to define application to be accessible, portal to be accessible, and access role to be given to an operator. Okay, now this is access role. You know about portals, you know about applications. Already we have discussed. Now this is access role. Let me open one of the access role. This is how an access role looks like. But how to create all this, it is there in the video creation. See, if you are going to open the access role, it has to show the instances. Hang on. Otherwise, I'll open in reverse order. Why is it not showing anything? Records security category, just hang on. Access role to object flows. Let's see. Okay, it is not giving anything, but let me show you by creation. So look at here now. This is access role to object. Access role to object is going to define the access level, your access level, to do something in PRPC environment. So here you can see open instances. What do you mean by open instances? What do you mean by open instances? Instance means it can be any role. Any role, if you want to open, you should have this access. Modify instances means updating a rule, and delete instances means deleting a rule. Run reports, execution of reports, execute activities. Run reports means execution of reports, execute activities means execution of activities. And again, open rules, modify rules, delete rules. Here you can understand instances like work objects. Here it is specific instances of rules that can be data instances above one or work objects. This is rule instances related. Open rules, modify rules, delete rules. What are these numbers here? If you look at on the right side, 5 is equal to production, 4 is equal to pre-production, 3 test, 4 2 development, 1 experimental. These are called server environments. See, in your real time, you will be having case study environment, development that you may be having, depends. Case study environment, development environment, test environment, pre-production or UAT environment, and live environment called production environment. These are the environments. You buy the license from Pega Systems, you install Pega PRPC software in development machine and test machine, test server, and the other one is UAT server, live servers, same product. At runtime, process commander, how it recognizes this is test environment. As a person, you know that you have set up like this. This is for testing, this is for UAT, this is for production, this is for this one. But how process commander knows this is live server and all? For that, PRPC will follow numbering. Look at here. Records, sysadmin. After you install PRPC, you need to log into PRPC and open this instance called system. System instance. If you open system instance, in system instance, you mention the production level. You have mentioned how much? 2. If you mention 2, process command recognizes this as a development environment. You mention 3 here, it is going to recognize you as a this server as a testing server. 4 you mention UAT server. 5 you mention live server. That is the identification for PRPC. It is there within PRPC. By default, Pega product will come with 2. After you install, open this rule. This is data instance, right? Can directly open and modify it accordingly. Done, modification is done. Now I want, suppose there are 2 operators. One operator can create rules, modify rules, delete rules. But other operator, I do not want him to create, modify, delete. That is manager operator. So I wanted to prevent when manager operator log into development environment, let's say, I do not want him to give the access to create or modify all these rules. For that, what we need to do is, now we need to create a role to object. In the role to object, I'll be giving open rules, modify rules, delete rules, number one. One, I have given one. This has been given. Now, this access role to object will be added into access role. Look at here, just give me 1 minute. Where is role to object? This one, right? What is the name? This is the name. Just look at here. I am going to create access role. But you can simply say you did not work on creation of all these, because you will not be getting chance to do all this, I'm pretty much sure. Where is access role under security category? Access role name. Okay. Now I'm creating access role name. This is base class related. Okay. Now testing. I'm giving the name as testing. I've given create and open. While creating access role to object, okay. Fine, no problem. Access role, did I save that or not? Testing, I have given framework level, create and open. What is that I am creating? Access role I have created, just empty. There is nothing available inside this access role. Save and then check in. As of now, check in. Now, I am creating role to object. So I have a role to object like this. This is role to object. I am creating a role to object, create test in role name. Now role to object you are linking with role. While creating itself, you are linking with role. Look at here. I am linking with the role. Access class. What is the class? HDFC. I am giving framework level. Or you can give at that base class also. No worries. At that base class. Create and open, and then I am giving open instances 3, modify instances 3, delete instances, data related this is, run reports 3, execute reports 3, execute activities 3, open rules 1, modify rules 1, delete rules 1. This is how I have given. Save this and wait for some time. Security tab, history tab, I'm sorry. Save this, completed. Now you remember, while we are creating this access role to object, I have linked this with role which is already available. Go back to role. If you refresh this, it should display. That role to object should be displayed here. I don't know why this version is not displaying, but still, if you can see, it will be there in video for sure. Access role name, right? Otherwise, you need to restart once the server done. Now you got it. Previously, there was nothing. The role to object which you have added there while creating role to object when you link with role name, that has been synced here. Now where would you call role name? Access role name we will call in operator rule form. You open operator. For the operator, go to access group. Go to access group, and here you call access role name. So I created role to role name. Role to object is created linked with role name. Role name is added into access group. Access group is given to some operator. Okay. When you log into BRPC, based on your role name, what is the role to object? Based on that, you will be getting access. I'll tell you how you will get access now. Look at here. See, at runtime, when you log into BRPC, BRPC will first recognize what is the system rule production level. Let's say you have logged into, manager has logged into which environment? Test environment. Manager has access to this one. Just give me a minute. Manager has this role to object assigned to a role name. That role name I have assigned to manager one. That manager one has logged into PRPC server, where the PRPC server is number 2. Production level is 2. So now production level 2 means that is development server or your development server. He has logged into there. Now he is going to modify one of the rule. Modify means anyway, you will not get that update button and all. Check out. he is not getting because his access level to modify the rules is 1 compared to the current server. 1 is less than 2. This number 1 is less than 2. That means he will not see anything like open rules, modify rules, delete rules, related buttons and all, he will not see. For rule instances, suppose another operator has logged into same server. For other operator, when he log in, in his access group, access role, role to object, it is defining 3. It is defining 3. 3 will be matched against the server on which he logged in. 3 is greater than or equal to 2, greater than 2. So because his access level, what is mentioned here is more than server level, he will be able to open the rules, update the rules, delete the rules. Suppose his access level is 2, equal to also no problem, it will allow. So whenever you log into VRPC, you will be given with some numbers. It is not directly in your operator rule form. Your operator will be connected to access role, access group. Access group is connected to access role. Role will have role to object, which defines numbers related to your access. These numbers will be compared with current system number. Current system number is greater than the number what you have. That particular access will be rejected. This is clear. Same operator, when you open any data instance, will you be able to delete it or not? Delete button you will see for data instances. Same operator will not see the delete button for rule instances when you log into environment 2, because open data instances and all is greater number compared to current server number production level 2. That's how your access will be restricted in backup. Everyone clear? So you will be able to run the reports from production level server 3 to below, but above 4 and 5, suppose this operator has logged into development server. Development server number is 2. He wanted to execute activities. He will be able to execute activities because execute activities is 3, that is greater than 2. Same operator, when he log into below environment, he will not be, okay, I'm sorry, I'm telling reverse or what? Correct enough. So this operator, when he log into environment 2, he will be able to execute activities. If this operator log into environment 3 also, will be able to do it, matching. If this operator log into UAT environment, for UAT environment, execution of activities is prevented. Okay, suppose you give the number, nothing you have given, blank, empty means 0, no access at all. So if you leave it empty also, no problem, no access. Everyone clear with this? So this is up to role to object. Role to object will be applicable at what level? Access role, which is applicable at access group level. That means one or more operators will share this. Suppose I want like this. I have access to execute reports, execute activities. So there is an operator. This operator has execute activities in a particular server. But in the same server, I do not want him to execute only one of the activity. Only one of the activity should not be able to execute. Remaining activities he should be able to execute. That is the requirement. So far everyone clear? Access role to object, how it will identify the numbers. Numbers will be compared with system rule, production level number. If the number here is equal to or less than, he is allowed. Number here is equal to or greater, he is allowed. Otherwise he is not allowed. If you compare system production level as a primary number, that number should be equal to or less than the number what is given here. Okay, vice versa. Now look at here. Suppose this operator has access to execute all the activities that is already given to him, but one of the activities should not be able to execute. This is the need. Business is saying like this. Business has an activity that should never be executable by anyone else. Only one operator they wanted to give. Okay, if you want Harsha, to do this, that can be achieved by using privileges.
Harsha.
Yes, please.
For example, yeah, for the server level we given as a 2. So 2 means like development, right?
Yes.
So then in the security, can you please go to the security tab?
Security.
So yeah, in the security, for example, run reports as 3 and execute activities 3. So then we can able to run those, or
server number is 2 and access what you have is 3. Your number is greater than server number or not? You'll be able to do it or not?
Okay.
You'll be able to do it. Suppose you log into server 4,
Okay. Then I can.
Server core, if you login, it is very simple. When you login VRPC, it will match your role to object numbers with server production level number. So any production level, production number, current number plus below compared to your number. Suppose your product, your role to object number is 3, you should be able to access, do that from server production level 3 and below. Above, will not be able to.
Okay.
This is clear?
Yeah, yeah. So the, if the server number is 4, then we cannot able to access anything.
No, like, you are not, will not be able to execute activities here in this case. You will not be able to do all this because server number 4, you will not be able to do all this. Suppose if I give 4 here, server 4 also you will be able to open instances. Remaining to modify, delete, not possible. Server 4 and below, you can open instances. Server 5, you will not be able to even open instances. If I give all 5, I'll be able to do anything in production, UAT, development, everywhere. 5 server and below servers also. Clear? Okay.
Yes, got it.
Now my requirement is, one of the rule that can be flow action, that can be activity or anything. You have access to execute all flow actions, all flows, all this one, what is that? All activities and all. But here and there few rules you wanted to prevent for this operator. What you need to do is, now you need to create something called, what is that? Privilege. Open privilege. I'm sorry. Privilege rule. So if you're creating privilege rule, there will be nothing inside privilege rule. If you just observe this, is there anything to define inside privilege rule? Anything to define? What it is asking? Role name it is asking. But do we have any option to edit and add role name? No. Now look at here, this privilege, just imagine I can call privilege on role to object, one or more privileges. I can call on role to object. What is the privilege I created now? This is the privilege. Save this, wait for some time, and then close this, open the privilege, where is it? Like how it has prefilled before, now it has prefilled. That means this privilege is now having access level of what level? That is again role to object only. For example, let's say role to object what I have created. For, there is an operator, access group, access role, role to object. These are straightforward connections. That role to object is defining everything 5. Just imagine. Means everything is there 5 in that role to object. I have one more role to object. Role to object 2. Okay, now that role to object is saying, is having one privilege. Okay, whatever it can be. Privilege name is P1, role to object is R2. In that R2, I have given everything 1. Okay, this is clear, everyone? Separate, I am talking about. One role to object is connected to your access group ultimately. Another role to object, independent, is there with privilege, connected with privilege, and some access role, something it can be. Okay. Now you open a role activity. Where is it? Where do we have activities? Okay, I'll give you another numbers, not 5. 5 does you will not be able to understand 5. Security tab. You have option to choose privilege. Okay, you choose a privilege. Okay, some privilege you have chosen. Let me tell you the numbers again. In my operator access group related role to object, I have number 3. Okay. Now there is another role to object which is defining numbers 1. Number 1. Okay, number 1. Okay. And now the privilege you can call on individual roles. You are going to call privilege on individual rules. Now you have logged into a server. I have to give it different actually. I'm sorry. Privilege is 5. Privilege is having a role to object 5. My operator's access group role to object has number 3. Privilege role to object is defining number 5. This is clear, everyone. Now this privilege. So now you have logged into server 3. When you log into server 3, because your numbers are 3 right in your role to object, that means every activity which is matching, right? 3, 2, 1, you should be able to execute activities. No worries. That is, up to that, everyone clear? Now, one of the activity is having a privilege. This privilege is connected to another role to object. That role to object is defining as five. Now, after your comparison is done, your operator with server level is completed, PRPC will also check privilege related role to object. Privilege related role to object, which is called on this activity, is mentioning five. Your operator and server is three, and privilege is defining five. Now, should you be able to execute or not? You will not be able to execute. This is what, again, this is also role to object concept only, but only thing is, you are bringing up that role to object access level till rule level. Your role to object added into access role, added into access group, and given to operators, that is whole system level, whole operator access group level. This is rule level. If you wanted to apply any of the access privileges, one specific rule, role to object you cannot call here. Suppose there is a role to object with number 5, okay, that is added to you. That means you will be able to execute anything from, okay, let's say 3, server 3 and below servers, you will be able to do anything. There is another role to object, for example, that is saying 2, okay, 2 or 5 or. That is saying 4, okay, and you have 3, and the role to object which is added is 4. 4 is greater than 3, what is there with the server, you will not be able to execute it. But role to objects you cannot call on individual rules. To make that available on individual rules, Pega has come up with one intermediate rule called privilege. Difference between role to object and privilege is, role to object ultimately will connect to privilege will ultimately connect to role to object only. But only thing is, this privilege, when you call on, you can call on individual rules. If you go to flow action security tab, you have option of privilege. If you go to flow one of the tab, you have option of privilege. Privilege is again connected to role to object, which can be brought up to individual rule. But role to object you cannot apply on individual rules. Role to object you can apply only on access group level. This is clear. So in my access group, I have 10 operators. 10 operators will be having same role to objects or not? Access group is same means same role to object, but my requirement is different. That is, 10 operators have same access group, okay, same role to objects, okay. At some times, 2 or 3 operators, I do not want to execute some of the roles, but by access group, operator access group role, access role and role to object, everyone should be able to do same tasks, same level of tasks. But 2 of the operators at certain roles, I do want to prevent them to execute something. For that, what should I do? I have to create not 2 of the operators I'm calling. For 2 of the roles, I wanted to prevent something. Then I have to create privilege with a separate role to object with less access and call that privilege on the rule level. Those will not be executable at runtime. Okay, this is privilege. Now, another requirement which I have told you now. There is another requirement, that is, all operators in access group will have same access level because those will be connected to same role names and role to objects. My requirement is 2 or 3 operators should not be able to do something. This is a requirement. So everyone is executing all activities. I want everything. But for 2 of the operators, only 2 of the operators, I do not want specific activities to be not executed. If this is the requirement, this cannot be done by privilege. Because if you add privilege on the rule, what will happen? That is applicable to at runtime every operator, it will be checking. So my requirement is only for 2 of the activities, only few of the operators should not be able to do something. In this case, we will not go by numbers. Numbers will not give you result. I mean, like required behavior. Where is role to object? Okay, I'll tell you another way around. Let's say role to object is defining value 4. That means if you log into server 4 and below servers, you will be able to access. 5th server, you will not be able to do something. My requirement is like this. Server 1, 3, 5. This operator should be able to access, but 2 and 4, you should not be able to access. Some rules, whatever it is. Can that be achievable using these numbers? One role to object you have to define. That role to object behavior should be like this. It should provide access for a particular operator, something like that, to execute something in 1, 3, 5, but not 2 and 4. Is it possible by numbers? It is not possible by numbers, because numbers will talk about current server and below servers. Okay, but in between, if you want to leave something, numbers won't work. In that case, we come up with when rules. These are called access when, similar to when rule only, but this is an instance of class rule access when. Rule obj when is normal when rule. This is rule access when. Suppose what is when rule? When rule is going to define condition. If you log in, this condition will be verified. Condition is satisfied, then you have access to that particular rule in that server. Otherwise, you don't have access to that server. So now this is going to satisfy a situation where you can access few of the servers, you cannot access few of the servers if condition is satisfied. Suppose in your operator ID, let's say for example, your role is access role is, your position, job position is manager. I want manager to access 1, 3, 5, but not 2, 4. How to write the logic now? The numbers will not help you. Now you create an access role, operator ID dot py job position is equal to, what is the value? Manager. If you write like that, then if you are going to log into PRPC, as your manager operator ID will be verified with this one. Okay, then you will be able to access whichever is matching, other one you will not be able to access, something like that. Okay, condition can be anything, it's not only this one. It can be whichever the server satisfies the condition, in that server you should be able to do that particular task, else you will not be able to do that. Execute activities, there is an access when. That condition is satisfied in server 1, server 3, server 5 for a particular operator. So he can execute activities in 1, 3, 5. He will not be able to do it in 2 and 4. That can be achievable by using access when rules, which is an instance of class rule access when. Other than this, there is something else. Access role to object, other than that, access deny is there. Something called access deny. Just for your information, as you have asked, I am talking about all these things. Access deny. Go ahead here. Look at here. Open all engineering. Surname query adjustment. I think they've stopped using access denies. That's why it is not there much.
No, you have reached the maximum.
No. Only one is there. Why? There should be n number actually. Access deny. This is access deny. You can tell me by the name itself. It is also defining numbers. Can you tell me how it works? It is going to work reverse. చెప్పండి స్కూల్ దగ్గర ఏం కారు ఐటెన్ కార్ అంటే ఎవరిదన్న స్కూల్ దగ్గర వన్ మినిట్ ఆ రూమ్ లో అడగండి జస్ట్ ఆన్లైన్ రీసోర్స్ 1 మినిట్ ఒక నిమిషం చెప్తా మీకు చెప్తా ఉందో లేదో అప్పుడు మీరు కనుక్కోవచ్చు ఉండొచ్చు ఉండకపోవచ్చు కదా అందుకని ఐటెన్ కార్ ఎవరిదన్న ఉందా స్కూల్ దగ్గర అక్కడ ఆఫీస్ ముందు కాదు అక్కడ బ్లూమింగ్ డేల్సా బ్లూమింగ్ డేల్ స్కూల్ ముందు ఐటెన్ కార్ ఎవరిది లేదండి బస్ వచ్చి ఉంటుంది స్కూల్ బస్ బయటికి తీయాలో లోపల పెట్టాలో వెళ్ళి గేట్ ముందు పార్క్ చేసుకుంటాం. ఓకే, నౌ యాక్సెస్ డినై, యూ షుడ్ బి ఏబుల్ టు టెల్ మీ హౌ ఇట్ వర్క్స్. ఇట్ వర్క్స్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ రివర్స్ టు యాక్సెస్ రోల్ టు ఆబ్జెక్ట్. సపోజ్ ఐ హావ్ గివెన్ 3 హియర్, వాట్ సర్వర్స్ ఐ విల్ బి ఏబుల్ టు యాక్సెస్? 3, 4, ఐ యామ్ నాట్ ప్రీ మచ్ ష్యూర్ అబౌట్ 3, 4, 5 will be able to access. Below, they will not be able to access. Reverse of role to object. I'll tell you now. See, you have an access role. You can have more than one access role, right? Operator can have, in an access group, there can be more than one access role. Okay? For example, just imagine, I have role 1, role 2. Role 1 is connected to role 2 object. Role 2 is connected to this one. What is that? Deny, access deny, which is reverse. In role 1, it is saying execute activities 5. In role 2, it is saying execute activities 3. Execute activities, okay. Execute activities 3. 5, what does that mean? If you log into 1, 2, you will be able to execute, right? Access deny 3 means, what does that mean? If you log into 1, 2, you will not be able to execute. Now, which one will take priority at runtime, given 2 are available? Is that a minute? అదే నేను చెక్ చేయాలి తెలియదు డినైలో నాకు తెలియదు యాక్సెస్ రోల్ టు ఆబ్జెక్ట్ సో నౌ ఇఫ్ యు యాడ్ యాక్సెస్ రోల్స్ వన్ ఇస్ డిఫైనింగ్ డినై వన్ ఇస్ డిఫైనింగ్ access allow, access role to object. Highest priority always will be given to negative. Prevention will take the priority than allowing. This will be asked in interviews. Stop access checking once a relevant access role to object instance explicitly denies or grants access. Okay, this one I'll tell you. This one you understand? Suppose you have access deny, access role. Both are being called by two different roles in an operator. Which one will take priority? Deny. The order of execution will be first one. Let's say first one satisfied. Allowing. Next it will execute second one and see. Second one is denying. What happens now? You will be denied. If you do not want that to happen, you have to select this checkbox. If you select this checkbox, once something is matched, you do not bother about the same deny or execute. So first one is denied. You do not bother about second one allow. So first one is allow. You do not bother about second one deny when you select this checkbox. Don't select this checkbox. How it works? Always negative will take priority. Deny will take priority. Clear everyone? But if they ask in interviews, you will come to know only when you draft something about it. I don't have even documentation for this, but I have a video. That's why I did not document it. You can go back and watch the video once again.